ain't no gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Craft Farms here with another video coming at you. We are back to Farm Sim, and we are back on Dad's Farm. We're actually in a new save game. I had to start a new save game because of some foliage issues. I did some editing, as you can see here. I removed the bin complex here and replaced it with Meridian Hopper bins. So that way I can use the Farm King and Brant augers. And what I had done is I removed all of the grass that was here, and then both the grass texture and foliage layers that were here. But I forgot that, you know, when you do that and start a new save game, it it doesn't remove it. So I had to move everything to a new save game and do some changes. So we bought a John Deere 4320, the Farm King auger, Brant auger, and then we moved the air seeding setup, the land rolling setup, and the application setup into here. I also picked up a New Holland T8 435 and Kuhn RM450 mower. I know this tractor is overpowered, but I don't really care. I also picked up one other thing. I also picked up my fuel trailer. I just want to make sure I'm not catching this music on my mic. I have a Facebook live stream playing on my phone of Dylan Schneider. Go check him out. He's a 16-year-old country music singer. He's going to be having his first album come out on July 29th. So, yeah, you guys should totally go check him out. But, yeah, so bins definitely aren't straight, but it's kind of hard to get them perfect. And then I, off-camera, finished. We've got fields 14... So 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 all have manure on them. I spread all the ones that needed to be spread, and we are currently working on 3. And our versatile is on his way to the container, getting another load of slurry. So we will run over there and make sure that we can top off that trailer. Yeah, I am going to make a few more changes to this map, but it's just going to be building changes, so I won't have to do any save game changes. I'm just going to change some scales. I'm going to add a scale to the main farm. Well, no, I'm not. I am going to change the scales that are at the elevators and then add functioning grain probes to them as well, rather than the ones that are on there that don't have any function. So yeah, I'm going to do that, and then that'll be all the changes that I do. So yeah, we're still at the slurry. There's probably going to be a couple more episodes of this. Trying to get it done, guys, so that way I don't have to see it anymore, but we still got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We got 10 fields left yet. So just bear with me and we'll get through it. Whoa, we're going to run over here. All right, and tanks full. Our container is full, so let's go pick up another load, because by the time that we get back, he should be just about empty again, and should be on his way to fill up. Excuse me. I'm getting tired. It's only 8 o'clock at night, though, but... This is crazy. There's people, like, asking him for his number, asking him for his address. Oh, man. People are crazy. So, yeah. I figured out what I'm going to do for the crops. Or I've decided. So, fields 9, 10, well, 9 through 16 are all going to be beans. And then 5 through 8 will be corn. Or no, excuse me. 3 through 8 will be corn. So, that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 will all be corn. And then 1 and 2 will be in wheat. So for our herbicides, we will need... So 1 and 2 will need B and C. And then the cornfields need A and C. And then soybeans need A and B. So quite a few different herbicides going on there. I need to plug my phone in before it dies. So yeah, it definitely will be interesting getting to all of these bins with the auger. Definitely going to have to do some pretty crazy angles. I am going to have to sell the slurry point once harvest is complete, and I'll have to put it somewhere else. I might put it back by that larger shed. In fact, we could actually do that right now. So we'll first off buy another one. So we will put it right there. And then we'll go and sell. There it is. We'll go and sell that one. There we go. So now so yeah, now we will have a different spot to go get slurry, and now we shouldn't be in the way of the auger come harvest season. Yeah, this is what I've been sitting doing lately, just sitting here carting slurry back and forth. But it will definitely be worth it once harvest comes around, because we'll get a very good yield. Hopefully we have enough storage for everything. I would hope so. And I guess if not, we'll just have to haul it to the elevator. So yeah, that'll be kind of annoying to have to do. It'd be a lot nicer to just take it and store it and wait for a great demand before we sell it, but does not always work that way. So let's kind of ride along with this guy a little bit. Oh my god. Some of the people commenting on the guy's live stream are crazy. Alright, so he's just about empty. So yeah, we've spent over 4 hours spreading slurry so far. And hopefully by next Tuesday's video, it should be completely done, because this is, it's getting old for me even. So yeah, once we finish all of this slurry, then we will have to go through and plow it all, which is going to take a fair amount of time as well. I don't know why the course just like drops off right there. That's kind of weird. But yeah, so we'll have a lot of plowing to do. And then after that, we'll be doing some spraying and then cultivating and then more. Then we'll go through and roll all the fields to add moisture, and then we'll plant and then spray our second herbicide, and then should be good to go for harvest after that. Let's just see where we're at. So not sure if this is going to end up being the full half hour or not. There's a feed bunk under there. I always think it's funny to see what's sitting underground on maps. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the ATS video. Gonna try and do some more of those, just kind of change it up. Because I know there's a lot of people out there that enjoy ATS. And I know a lot of my viewers enjoy FarmSim, and I know some of them enjoy both. So hopefully can make everybody happy, we'll see. Boy, this thing will really light up the night. Wow. So while I'm thinking about it, I also want to do placeable fuel, because this one you only have limited capacity. So I think that would also be neat, because I don't think there's actually fuel here at this farm. In fact, I'm not even sure where you go to get fuel. Put that there. And we also need a pressure washer, because we do not have one. And then that will go right there. So that'll be kind of the washing, fueling up spot. We'll take a few screenshots here. We better close this door back up. Alright, we're good to go. Good to go back for another load of poop. So yeah, I downloaded a trial version of Marillus Action. It actually worked really, really well. It didn't drop my frame rate at all. But, you know, with the free version, right here, there was a big action symbol. Or, you know, saying this was made in action or whatever. So I can't really use it right now, and I can't buy it either at this moment. I guess I'd have to go back and look at the price. Maybe I would be able to buy it, but I think that's what Ian Robson uses. I have to double check with him because I know his program works really well, he said. So I'm going to have to ask him and just kind of see, make sure that that's the one that he uses, and would have to buy it and check it out, see what it's like. Maybe it'll be a lot better than Open Broadcaster. Hopefully, because it gets really annoying to go from playing with 60 frames per second when I'm not recording to once I hit record, I'm dropping to like 30 and under and getting a lot more lag in the farmyard. It's really a pain in the butt to have that happen all the time because it decreases my video quality. You know, my video isn't as good of quality then, so that's really kind of an annoying issue. But so yeah, if we run over here to the fuel tank here, and I cannot get rid of this lag. My goodness. Should tell me here somewhere how much fuel's in it. Ah, 1,000 liters, that's it. Oh, that's only 13%. We could haul a little fuel, I guess. Show you guys my fuel trailer in action. I don't know if I've used it in a series yet or not. I don't believe I have. I'm not entirely sure, I guess. Yeah, this lag is driving me nuts. So we'll run into town and get some fuel. I'm pretty sure that there's a fuel station on this map. I sure hope, anyways. If not, I might have to go in and add one somewhere or something. Maybe add one of the, like the co-op, maybe you'll have fuel or something. It's not looking very promising as of yet, and yep. But it's showing that there's fuel at this farm. I think. Yeah, it's showing there's fuel here. So maybe these guys will be our supplier. Oh yeah, there's a fuel barrel right there. Alright, so we'll fill up with some fuel here. So yeah, this should top off our fuel, at least for the most part. We'll have to get another load of slurry to the container pretty soon. That guy is empty. So I guess we'll drop this off at the farm and let this start emptying. And then we'll bring another load of slurry out. The only bad thing about slurry is it slurry and manure, I guess, they run out really, really fast. So yeah, let me know, guys, if you want to see me do the beef cattle on here as well. Because if you guys want to see it, then I will try and get to it. If you guys want to see it and I do it, it may not be like right away. I may wait until like once harvest ends or something like that. Once we get to there, and then we'll start the animals, maybe. I'm not sure. I'll decide that when that time comes, I guess. When you guys decide what you would like to see. So, I put the tanks in backwards. Okay, I need to get it so I have good frame rate. So that I can place this thing. My goodness. There we go. So we need to sell this one first. Okay, and then we need to buy a new one. Oops, too far. Too far. So I want to put it right there. That'll work. Ah, it auto-empties. And it empties fast. Or the thing itself auto-fills, I should say. Okay, let's head on out with another load. So yeah, you guys, like I said, I'm going to check it out and might get Marillus action instead. Because, like I said, the free trial, maybe what I'll do is I'll install the free trial again and just do, like, some testing around with it. Just to get familiar with it and make sure that I can live stream to YouTube with it and do a test stream and then do a recording and upload the recording as a test. Just so you guys can kind of see it and, you know, tell me if you guys think it's a whole lot better and if I should go for it. Because if you guys want to see me get it, then I totally will. As long as I am able to, anyways. So our versatile is full and on his way to continue spreading. So we'll run up and top off the tank, the container. So he's on his last little bit of headland as well. And then he will be moving on to the ups and downs. You can see him going right there. Yeah, so many people have told me to get, like, Fraps or Bandicam, but both of those are terrible. Fraps really kills your computer, and Bandicam is just not that great in general. So I have tried those before, and they were terrible. Fraps just kills your CPU. You know, and it kicked my fans in right away, just about. So, because, you know, like, it You know, and I hadn't been doing anything that my fans should have been kicking in prior to that, so it was crazy. So I think we'll end the video there. We're at about 25 minutes and we're doing the same thing, so I think I'll end it. What I'm going to do off camera is try and get as much slurry spread as I can. Hopefully we should be done with fields 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's going to be my goal. And then so that way in Thursday's episode, actually, I think what I might do is do Farm Sim on Tuesdays and Saturdays and then do American Truck Sim on Thursday. Well, I'll kind of wait, I guess. You guys let me know if you want to see more ATS, and if you do, then next week I will do that. Start that where I do Farm Sim on Tuesdays and Saturdays and then ATS on Thursday. But so for Thursday's video, I'm going to hope to have fields 1, 2, 3, and 4 done. And then we'll be working on, you know, field 5 or field 7 or whatever. So that's my hope, is to have all that done. I will also finish hauling fuel and get our fuel storage all topped off, as we will be needing some fuel very, very soon in our slurry equipment. Starting to get down there in fuel. Even this is starting to get little ways down there on fuel. It's not like it's in any danger of getting low anytime soon, but it's also not that full anymore. So, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to, okay. I just totally messed up my ending. Thank you guys for watching. As always, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Make sure to turn on my post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central Time and Saturdays at noon Central. Live streams are whenever. Going to be getting into those again soon. I know I say that in every video almost, but I promise that we'll be getting there soon. Don't forget to check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching.